A plea for help comes to an end with three people kidnapped and robbed at gunpoint.
News Channel 8's Laura Nichols talks with one of the kidnapping victims.
19-year-old Nick Broderick told me he thought he was going to die last night. Here's the story of how he and his two friends got out alive.
They weren't really saying too much. They just said drive and look straight ahead, or that's it, or I will shoot you.
A quick stop at a liquor store for cigarettes last night ended with Nick Broderick and his two friends, brothers Dylan and Blake, kidnapped and robbed at gunpoint.
My friend was just coming back with cigarettes.
The victim came out. He was approached by an individual asking for change. Our victim said that he would give him some change in just a minute. And when he wasn't paying attention, another suspect approached.
And I was in the back seat. And all of a sudden, I just knew that there was two big guys in our car with a gun.
The suspects told them to drive to the south side, where they picked up a third man.
I was just so scared. Nothing like that has ever happened to me before.
And from there, they went to an apartment complex near Southwest 9th Street.
It took us, like, these kind of shady apartments and, like, put us in, like, the laundry room.
It was here where the three men took Blake, Dylan, and Nick to a laundry room. They told them to turn around, pointed guns at their heads, and then robbed them.
After taking their backpacks and wallets, the three suspects ran away.
They just said, you stay there. And then they just took off.
All three teens are okay, and even though it was scary,
the most horrific thing that happened to me,
they're happy to walk out alive.
I got off pretty lucky.
We talked with the mother of the other two teen victims. She said one of her sons was at work and the other was still so frightened he didn't want to talk. Police say they are searching the car for any physical evidence. Here is the descriptions of the three suspects. All three are described as black males between 5'8 and 6'1 wearing hooded sweatshirts.
Any surveillance video from that liquor store that police could use?
The police said they just obtained the surveillance video. They think one of the suspects was maybe buying food inside, so they're going to look at the video and see if they can find him.
Okay. Laura, thank you.